ॐ सहनावतु सहनौभुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोद् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं पादम् शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरम् उद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् Mahasayagara said, when Shvetaketu said, Bhu eva ma bhagavan vijñāpayatu iti, the revered sir may please explain to me with an illustration. Mahasayagara explained this, āchāryavān vidvān yena kramena sat sampadyate. Acharyavan, Vidwan, Vidwan, this wise person, Acharyavan, who has been taught by a competent teacher and who has gained the knowledge. Yena kramena sat sampadyate. What's the sequence in which he attains oneness with Sat? You say, tasya tavadeva charam yavanda vimokshe atha sampatsye. Atha. As soon as the body drops off, sat sampatsyate, then he becomes one with sat. This is a question of krama, but then kena kramena sat sampadyate. You can say what's the sequence in which he departs from this body, that's all you can say. If for the wise person, the identification with sat is immediately, as soon as the body drops off, there is oneness with sat, because just as the part space always was the total space, mahakasha, an apparent barrier in the form of tholakava yoshokara. Hmm? So then, just as the pot space is the Mahakasa total space, it is not as has to become one. But accepting that there is some kind of a separation because of the walls of the pot, that imaginary separation goes away, that's all you can say, as though separation goes away. So it is not sat sampatti, meaning becoming one with sat, or attaining sat, or identifying with sat, is owning up what is, in fact. So there can be no krama or sequence in terms of how he identifies with it. The sequence can be in terms of how he departs from this body. Anyway, yena kramena sat sampadyate, the sequence in which he attains oneness with sat. Tam kramam drishtantena bhuyema bhagavan vijnapayaduiti. See, Bhashyakara constructs this question. Every time Svetakura says, Bhuyama Bhagavan Vijnapayatviti, Bhagavan, the revered sir, may please explain to me again. What is asking for? It's to be derived from the following passage. So what follows this, comes subsequently, is what determines what must be the question in the mind of Svetaketu. When Svetaketu says, please explain to him again, so father understands it in some way and then replies. Because Svetaketu does not seem to clearly say what it is that he wants to know and what is the question in his mind. But father seems to understand and replies that. So what that understanding is on the part of father is what Bhashyakara here brings out. So from what follows, there is a sequence. Therefore, the question is, in what sequence does the wise person become one with Sat? अर्चिरादि मार्ग प्राप्त्या वा अत्रैव अविद्या निवृत्ति मात्रेण वा सत्संपत्ति इति संदिहान शंकते. This is the wise person travels after departure from his body along the northern path of northern solstice, characterized by Archihi, the flame, etc. Or अत्रैव, here itself, अविद्या निवृत्ति मात्रेण, merely by the dispelling of ignorance. Sat sampatti, his oneness with Sat is as a result of traveling through a passage, or is it simply the removal of ignorance? Says also in the Tika, line 28, Paradevata Sampatti Sampatti Paryantam Vidvat Avidoshoho Samanaha. This topic came earlier also as to how a person becomes, how does he merge into Sat after death. So in the deep sleep, after death, at the time of death, and in Pralaya, in all the three states. In deep sleep, at the time of death, and in Pralaya, the dissolution, the jiva merges into Sat. So this is true for everybody. Vidvat avidushoho samanaha paradevata sampatti paryantam kramah. The krama of the sequence up to the becoming one with Sat is samanaha, the same for enlightened person as well as an ignorant person. Avidvamstu punaravartate, vidvamstu atyantikameva sampadyate na punaravartate. that ignorant person comes back from, even after being merged in sat, the ignorant person comes back. Merger is not total merger. He retains his samskara. Just as in deep sleep also, a person retains the samskaras, ignorance. And all that is born of ignorance, avidya, kama, karma, all of this is retained. Therefore, he comes back. After death also, for an ignorant person, those samskaras remain which require him or which force him to again come back to the same old body, a similar body. So that's the difference between the vidwan and avidwan. Archiradimagastu na vidushah kintu sagunopasakascheti. Whereas the passage along the northern solstice is not for the Brahmagnani nor a Brahman, but Saguna Upasaka, for the one who meditates upon Saguna Brahman. Iti abhipretya. Keeping all of this in mind, the father said, Tatha Somya iti hovacha. May it be so, he Somya. Now on page 283, we go to the next passage. Purusham Somya Uta Upatapinam Jnataya Paryupasade Janasimam Janasimamide Tasya Yavata Navang Manasya Sampadyade Manav Prane Pranas Tejasi Tejas Parasyam Devatayam Tavad Janati. He Somya, Purusham Somya, Purusham Upatapinam. A person who is ailing, Upatapinam. Jvara, so Gnata hai Paryupasate, when the person is dying. That time, the relatives and the family members surround him, nurse him, ask him, Janasimam, Janasimam iti. The father says, hey, do you recognize me? The son says, do you recognize me? Do you hear me? Yavat, so tavat janati. So long this person responds, yes, I see you. In some way, he may not be able to talk, but through even the movement, eyes, you know, the expression in eyes also, you can convey this. I can see you, I know who you are. Yavat na vang manasi sampadyade. Until this, merger has not taken place. So what is the process of merger? Vang manasi sampadyade. First of all, the speech merges into mind. Mana prane, the mind into the prana, the vital air. Prana tejasi, the vital air, tejas or element fire or in the warmth. Tejah parasyam devatayamiti and tejah. We are told that stands for five elements, stands for jiva in between. Parasyam devatayam. So jiva along with five elements merges into Parasyam Devatam, the supreme deity, meaning Sat. So until this does not, so as long as this does not happen, so long this person janati, he knows. That's all it says. So Bhashyakara says, Purusham He Somya Uta Upatapinam Jvaradi Upatapavantam Jnataya Bandhavaha Parivarya Upasate Mumurshum Janasimam Tavapitaram Putram Bhrataram Va Idi Prachantaha तस्य मुमूर्षोः यावत् न वाङ् मनसि सम्पद्यते मनः प्राणे प्राणस्तेजसि तेजः परस्यां देवतायाम् इत्येतत् उक्तार्थम्। पुरुषम उपतापिनम एन एलिंग पर्सन ज्वरादि उपतापवंतम एलिंग बिकॉज ऑफ फीवर एक्सेट्रा ज्ञातयः मिस बांधवाः ज्ञातयः हिज रिलेटिव्स हिज फैमिली मेंबर्स परिवारी उपासते सो दे सराउंड हिम एंड दे उपासते नर्स हिम इन द लास्ट मोमेंट Mumushum, the one who is dying. Literally, mumushum means one who wants to die, but mumushum means one who is dying. You know, Janasi mam to apitaram. Hey, do you recognize me? I'm your father. Putram, do you recognize me? I'm your son. Bhrataram, do you recognize me? I'm your brother. So when this is happening, tasya mumushoho. Of that dying person, yavat as long as vang manasi na sampadyate, the speech is not yet merged into the mind, and mind into prana, and prana into the fire or tejas, and tejas into sat sampat, parasyam devata, tavat yavat tavat janati. So as long as this process of merger into the Paraspara Devata or Sat has not taken place, so long he knows. Okay? We go to the next page now. Let us read the next passage. Atha yada asya vang manasi sampadyate manah prane pranas tejasi tejas parasyam devatayam atha na janati atha. However, यदा अस्य वांग मनसि संपद्यते फेन दिस डाइंग पर्सन द स्पीच मर्जेस इनटू माइंड मनः प्राणे द माइंड इनटू द वाइटल एयर प्राणस तेजसी द वाइटल इनटू तेजस और एलिमेंट फायर और वार्म्थ तेजस परस्याम देवताया एंड दैट इनटू द सुप्रीम डेइटी व्हेन इट हैपेंस अथ न जानाति देन दिस पर्सन does not know, meaning he is no consciousness anymore when this merger has taken place. When he is dead? So, going to Anandagiri, Nanu, Esha samsarana manana kramaha, natu vidushaha sat sambatti kramaha. From the description, looks like this is a sequence in which a samsari or an ignorant person or an ordinary person meets with his death. I mean, you know, he dies. So this krama sequence looks like for a common person. Nudu vidusha sat sampatti krama. Because this same description came earlier for everybody with reference to deep sleep, pralaya or death. So this looks like, sounds like it's the same thing. Therefore, this sounds like the krama or the sequence in which an ordinary person dies. Natu vidusha sat sampatti kramaha. The description does not seem to be like a krama or sequence in which a wise person merges into sat. Doesn't look like that. Tayohu visheshasya vaktavyatva. So vishesha. The difference between the two, difference between the way the ignorant person dies and merges into sat, And the wise person after death merges into sat. That difference as a vaktavya has to be said. Shruti doesn't seem to say that. Atah aha, therefore Vashyakara says, samsaranahiti. If you go to the tika below, Purvam Svatna Khandikayam Khandika or Khandikaya, I guess must be same, you know. Purvam Svatna Khandikayam Maranakale Yasmin Sati Sampadyate Vidvan Avidvamsa Tathavidam Sadatmatvam Asti Jivasya Sarubhutam Idvaktum Maranakrama Uktah. Purvam Svatna Khandikayam. Svatna then sleep. So earlier when this Shruti described the sleep of a person, the deep sleep. Maranakale yasmin sati sampadyate. There at the time of death, in the deep sleep, or the death, or time of pralaya. Yasmin sati sampadyate vidvan avidvamsya. The sat in which both vidvan and avidvan, both of them merge. Tathāyavidam sadātmatmasti jīvasya sarubhūtamiti. See, the purpose of describing the deep sleep was how the jīva merges into sat in the deep sleep state. With the example of a shakuni of a bird, how the bird, seeking a refuge, flies here and there, and not finding a refuge, comes back to the same place where it is tied. Similarly also, the jivatma seeking a refuge in waking state, dream state, not finding an ashraya or a support or refuge, comes back to where he is tied, namely, so pranabandhanam is somya manah. Manam is jivatma, pranabandhanam. Pranam is Brahman. Brahman is bandhanam. He comes back to Brahma. So all of that description was to tell us that sat is the true nature of jiva. That in deep sleep state, now the jivatma comes back to its true nature, which is sat. So tathavidam sadatmasi jivasya swarubhutam. Jivasya swarubhutam. The swarub, the true nature of jiva is sadatmatvam. Of the nature of sat, that's the atma of the jiva. Idi vaktum maranakrama uktah. So there, the sequence of death was for vidvan as well as avidvan to say that sat is the true nature of a jiva. The same thing is stated here. So what is this? You know, it's punarukti. Idaniyam tu vidusha yaiva sat sampatti. Na archiradikramena iti vaktum. So then why the same passage appears to be repeated here? The purpose here is different. Purpose is different there, and purpose of the same description is different here. That the purpose was to convey that sat is the atma, the swarupam of jiva. Here this purpose of description, same passage is the vidvan becomes one with sat here only. Na archiradikramena, that a wise person does not require to travel along the northern solstice to become one with sat. Here itself, eva samaliyante, here itself he becomes one with sat. To say that is the purpose of this passage. Therefore, na pundarukti doshaya. This punarukti, repetition with reference to words, but not with reference to meaning. So punarukti can be in words, or punarukti can be in meaning. If punarukti is both words and meaning, then it's definitely punarukti. But the purpose of passage here is different. So what is the difference now? Ayam cha artha vishesha asyam eva khandikayam. Athana janati iti. So Tikakara has worked very hard really to find the difference is what this Khandika conveys. Bhashyakara doesn't seem to have you know, paid that much attention. But this Tikakara, what's the difference between the previous description and this description? Atha na janati, the last word, last sentence, atha na janati. Then when it is merged, then he does not know. Iti vishesha vijnana abhava uktihi. So that now the wise person does not have vishesha vijnanam. He does not have any vishesha, means any qualified knowledge. Samanya vijnanam is consciousness, that is his nature. Vishesha vijnanam, the specific knowledge, is the knowledge taking place in the mind as a vritti. He no more has that. So here itself, na janati, here itself, vishesha vijnana bhavaha, for the wise person. So this is a passage for a wise person saying that here itself now is free from vishesha vijnanam. What is vishesha vijnanam? The knowledge that comes when you have the mind, sense organs functioning, then there is vishesha vijnanam. So long you are still not merged in such. But when vishesha vijnanam, the particular knowledge, is not there, as in deep sleep, so also now there is no particular knowledge, means that as in deep sleep now, the wise person is merged into sat, here itself. So that's what this Tikakara says. Atha na janati is the extra thing that is stated here, is to say that the vidwan merges into sat here itself. So that is artha vishesha. So shabda is the same, but artha vishesha, the additional meaning or specific meaning is this here. So vishesha vijnana abhavakti dvara sara vyavahara abhavakte labhyate. So sara vyavahara abhava, that there is no vyavahara anymore for the wise person. Labhyate iti dastavyam. Kim labhyate? Ayam cha artha visheshah labhyate. This additional meaning or specific meaning is what we gain from this verse, atha na janati. He says that there is no vishesha vijnanam, therefore there is no vyavahara, there is no transaction at all, and therefore he is no more identified in this body or in this body. Nanu vidushaha mananakrame prashte samsariya mananakrame uchyate tadayuktam. So our question is, vidushaha mananakrame prashte. The question was, how does a wise man, how does he depart from this body? But the description here is the same as of an ordinary person. Samsari mananakrame uchyate. Shruti has said the same sequence of death in case of wise person is some same as samsari. Tat ayuktam, that doesn't sound right. There is some distinction between the way the wise person departs and the way the ignorant departs. Some distinction must be there to distinguish wise person from the ignorant. Mananakrama avishesh abhave mukti lakshana phala vishesha nasyad. So in what way do you know that the wise person has become liberated? There is something that distinguishes him as far as the maranakrama or the sequence of death is concerned. Then we know that he dies in this way, so he is a wise person. That's how he dies in a different way. He is an ignorant person. So maranakrama, the way the person dies, should reveal that this is the way the wise person dies. But the description is the same for an ignorant person also. Mukti lakshana phala vishesha na syad. So therefore, the phala vishesha. Phala vishesha is the distinction in the outcome. For an ignorant person, he comes back into samsara. For a wise person, he does not, because he is liberated, moksha. So if there is no difference in the way they die, then there is no difference also in the way they attain the result after death. Must be the same. So ignorant person comes back to samsara. Wise person also appears to die in the same way. Therefore, we would think that he also comes back to samsara. Iti ashankya vidya vishesha krita eva phal vishesha na maranakram vishesha krita iti. Phala, the result is determined by the knowledge and not by the way he dies. So vidya vishesha krita eva phal vishesha. The specific phala, namely moksha, that a wise person attains is due to vidya vishesha, the knowledge that he has of the self. Na marana krama vishesha kritaha, and not is not determined by the way in which he passes away. So that's what Bhashyakara says now. This tika says, yes, samsarinaha. Now that samsarinaya, that's how it is there. Samsarinaha. यो मरणक्रमः स एवायम् विदुषोपि सत्संपत्तिक्रमः इत्येतदाह परस्यां देवतायां तेजसंपन्ने अथ न जानाति. Samsarinaha, yeah, maranakramaha. The sequence of death for a samsari, for an ordinary person, for an ignorant person. Seva ayam vidushopi sat sambatti kramaha. Same is the krama of the sequence for a wise person also. The way the ignorant person comes to sat, becomes one with sat, is the same way in which the wise person also becomes one with sat. That is what sequence is the same. That's what the Shruti says. Parasyam devatayam tejasi sampanne. When the tejas or the warmth, so merged into parasyam devatayam, the supreme deity, atha na janati, then he does not know. Both is the same. For why is the ignorant the same thing? So says the Tika here on the page and the line 19. Yadyapi iyam kandika vidushayana. So Bhashyakara also seems to say the same thing. Therefore again this Tikakara clarifies, you know. Yadyapi iyam kandika vidushayava satsambhadikrama pradipadanartha. This kandika is vidushayava satsampatti pratipadanartha, that this kandika only does pratipadanam, delineates only the sequence in which the wise person departs. Why? Acharyavan vedayati tasyava prakritatvat. Here the topic under discussion is a wise person and not an ignorant person. Acharyavan veda tasyatavadevashiram yavandivimokshe adasampatshe. That is the description of the wise person. So the one who is in the discussion in the context is the wise person. Therefore, this description also applies to a wise person. Tathabi tejah parasyam devatayam athana janatiti anayashrutya. See, this one said, Tejah parasyam devatayam athana janati. So this second passage said that Tejah merges into the supreme deity, then it does not know. Iti anaya shrutya, this particular shruti passage. Tejah shabdite. So in the Brahma Sutra it was discussed how the word Tejas does not stand middle of element fire, but stands for all the five elements. And we must add one more step in between. These five elements merge into Jiva, and Jiva merges into the Supreme Deity. So, Teja Shabdite Jive Paradevata Shabdita Sadatma Sampanne Sati. So, when Teja merges into Sat, Tejas means the five elements, means Jiva, Atma, merges into Sat or the Supreme Deity. अनंतरम न जानाति सत्संपत्तिन्द्रमे विदुष विशेष विज्ञान अभाव उक्त्या। सो टीकाकार सेज न जानात अथ न जानाति इज द विशेष द डिफरेंस हियर बिटवीन व्हाट वाज सेड अर्लियर एंड व्हाट इज सेड हियर। So when the wise person has now become one with Sat, then atha means anantaram na janati. Thereafter he does not know. Iti Sat sampatti anantaram eva. That means that as soon as he becomes one with Sat, right away vidusha vishesha vijnana abhavoktya. So atha na janati, by saying that, the Shruti wants to convey that as soon as a wise person is merged into Sat, then there is absence of all particular knowledge. Sarvyavahara abhava lakshana vishesham bruvanaya. So this Shruti adds this and says that there is no more vyavahara for the wise person after he is merged in Sat. Tata puram arthad vayo tulyata uktairi bhavah. So parasyam devataya up to then is the description common to the wise and the other wise, but athana janati applies only to the wise person. That's what this tikakara says, because otherwise what's the difference between the description here and description earlier? Earlier description was common to everybody. This description should be for the wise person because that's the context. But the sequence appears to be similar for both. So what's the difference? Difference is athana janati. That is the additional statement. Atha means tadanantaram. As soon as you merge into sat, right then, na janati. No vishesha jnana is there, no vyavahara is there. Ita deva vidush avidushah punah vishesha vijnanari pratipadana purukam विदुषा तदभाव त्या दृढ़यति। सो दैट वंस दिस व्यवहार अभाव और एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑल व्यवहार टेक्स प्लेस इन केस ऑफ वाइज पर्सन दिस नो मोर व्यवहार। फॉर इग्नोरेंट पर्सन द व्यवहार कम्स बैक अगेन, दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू। एतदेव अविदुषः पुनः विशेष विज्ञानादि प्रतिपादन पूर्वकम्। The ignorant person going again into this vishesha vijnanam, the worldly knowledge and the worldly vyavahara transaction, and the wise person does not. So this is dhradayati bhashyakara, so makes it firm further avidvam. So bhashyakara says avidvamstu satah utthaya प्राग्भावितं व्याघ्रादिभावं देवमनुष्यादिभावं वा विशते। सो बोथ हैव मर्ज इन टू सत अविद्वांस। हाउएवर अविद्वान द इग्नोरेंट पर्सन सतः उत्थाय, फिफ्थ के सतः उत्थाय इमर्जिंग फ्रॉम सत। So says Anandagiri, satah tasmad agnyatat sadatmana sakashadityavatah yavat. From sat means what? Tasmad agnyatat sadatmana. That ignorant person also has merged into sat, but he doesn't know that I am merged into sat, doesn't know that I am sat. So even in spite of merging into Sat or Brahman, the Brahman is still unknown. Just as in deep sleep also, everybody merges into Brahman but does not know that I am merged in Brahman or that I have come out of Brahman. So that coming out is like that. For an ignorant person, he does not know that I become one with Brahman or that I am emerging from Brahman. He doesn't know. So agnyatat sadatmana sakashat. From Sadatma, the Sadhidatma, which is not known, from that he emerges. स्विद्वांसु सतः उत्थाय वर्ण उत्थाय सिद्ध टीका अहम एवं भूत एवं विशेष विज्ञानम लब्धा इत्यर्थ है। वट इज सामान्य ज्ञानम सत और एग्जिस्ट इन दर कॉन्शियसनेस, वट इज विशेष विज्ञानम आई एम सो एंड सो, अहम एवं भूत है, आई एम ए टाइगर, आई एम ए लायन, आई एम ए ह्यूमन बीइंग, इति एवं विशेष विज्ञानम लब्ध्वा दैट्स को उत्थानम। जस्ट एज वेन वी अराइज फ्रॉम डीप स्लीप ऑल्सो वी अराइज एंड डू दिस, नाउ इन डीप स्लीप स्टेज देर वॉज नो पर्टिकुलर नॉलेज, देर वॉज ओनली कॉन्शियसनेस, बट वेन आई वेक अप देन आई कम बैक टू पर्टिकुलर आई एम सो एंड सो, आई एम सो एंड सो वॉज नॉट देर इन डीप स्लीप स्टेट। Therefore, the deep sleep of even a king and a beggar is the same because there is no particular knowledge. In a waking state, the king knows I am the king, the beggar knows I am the beggar. That is called coming back to the particular knowledge. But in case of the wise person, in this case, the wise person does not come back to that particular knowledge, I am so and so. विशेष विज्ञान लाभ एव ही उत्थान मिति सुधि उत्थाय। हाउ द टीका वी कैन आस्क टीकाकार हाउ डू यू इंटरप्रेट द वर्ड उत्थाय राइजिंग फ्रॉम दैट एस आई एम सो एंड सो, सो अराइजिंग फ्रॉम सत इज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ दिस नोशन आई एम सो एंड सो आइडेंटिफाइंग विद द बॉडी माइंड कॉम्प्लेक्स। एतेभ्य भूतेभ्य समुत्थाय इत्यादि व्याख्यातमिति, meaning he comes, he identifies once again with those five elements. That identification went away in deep sleep, and then that identification comes, or when he dies also and comes to next body, again he identifies with these five elements, means identify with this upadhi. Then uthaya prag bhavatam vyagra vyagra adibhavam prag bhavatam. Bhavita means what was all the time thought of, Vyagradibhavam. So when this Jivatma was in the body of a tiger, all the time his awareness was, I am a tiger, I am a tiger, I am a tiger, I am a lion, I am a lion, I am a human, I am a mosquito. So this was a constant thought. As long as the jiva was in that particular body. So prag bhavitam vyagradibhavam, the state of being a tiger, which was all the time so held or entertained by this person, this jiva. Deva manushyadibhavam va, or it was deva bhava or manushya bhava, he comes back to the same bhava. So it is bhavad bhavantaram. Not from one body to the other, it is from one bhava to the bhava. So yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tejatyante kalevaram. Whatever bhava, with that he departs from this body, that's what he attains in the next embodiment. The tika says vyagraditi tamasa karmodbhave vyagradi bhavam satyakodbhave deva bhavam rajasetu मनुष्यादि भाव व तस्मिन्नेव शरीरे उत्क्रांते प्रागेव वासना मात्रेण उद्भूतं विशति तामस कर्मोद्भवे। इफ देयर इज प्रेडोमिनेंट तमस कर्म एंड सो डिपेंड्स अपॉन व्हाट इज द प्रेडोमिनेंस ऑफ द कर्म व्हेन दिस पर्सन डाइज, यू नो that is fine, but the Bhagavad Gita also says that rajasi pralayam gatva karma sangi sujayate tatha prinas tamasi moola yoni sujayate karmana subhrutasyahu sattvikam nirmalam phalam yada sattve pravruddhetu pralayam yati deha vruta तदोत्तम विदाम लोकान अमलान प्रतिपद्यते रजसि प्रलयं गत्वा कर्म योनि सुजायते तथा प्रहीनस्तमसि मूढ़ योनि सुजायते। सो देयरफॉर व्हेन द पर्सन डिपार्ट्स विद सत्व इज प्रेडोमिनेंट देन देवादि भावम राजसे तो मनुष्यादि भावम बिकम्स दो डाइज विद रस इन प्रेडोमिनेंस ऑफ रजस देन बिकम मनुष्य एटसेट्रा एंड तामस कर्मोद्भवे व्हेन ही डिपार्ट्स विद प्रेडोमिनेंस ऑफ तमोगुण देन ही कम्स टू ए तमोगुण देन मूढ़ योनि सुजायते। तस्मिन्नेव शरीरे उत्क्रांतेः प्रागेव वासनामात्रम् उद्भूतं विशति। ही एंटर सेम बॉडी नाउ दैट्स मीनिंग दैट व्हाट एवर द भावना इज देयर ड्यूरिंग द लाइफ दैट्स ए भावना दैट आल्सो अपीयर्स ए टाइम ऑफ डेथ एंड दैट्स व्हाट डिटरमिन्स इज नेक्स्ट एम्बॉडीमेंट। सो व्हेन ए जीवात्मा इज बॉर्न इज अ टाइगर then we imagine that, presume that while departing from the previous body, the thought of tiger must have come there at the end. That's how it becomes tiger. And why did the thought of tiger come at the end? Because that's the thought he must have entertained throughout his life. So in that sense we can say that prag bhavitam sada tad bhava bhavitah. He has entertained that bhavana all his life, that bhavana appears before the time of death and that's what determines his next embodiment. So it is not that a Vyagra becomes a Vyagra. A person gets, jiva gets according to his karma. So vasana matra udbhutam vishati. So now how do you say that? Then Tikakara quotes from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. हृदयस्य अग्रम प्रद्योतते तेन प्रद्योतेन एष आत्मा निष्क्रामति चक्षुष्टो चक्षुष्टो वा मूर्धना वा इति श्रुतेः। सो बृहदारण्यकोपनिषद् डिस्क्राइब्स हृदयस्य अग्रम प्रद्योतते द टाइम ऑफ डिपार्चर द अग्रम द टॉप ऑफ द हार्ट बिकम्स लाइटेड अप It shines, becomes lighted up. Tena pradyotena esha atma nishkamati. With that pradyota, with that knowledge, light of knowledge, this jiva atma departs from this body. Chakshustova mudnavayati. From the eyes or from the head, etc. He departs depending upon his karma. This is the savijnano bhavati. सविज्ञान अन्वक्रामते श्रुतेश्च सेम पैसेज सविज्ञान भवती। सो बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद सेड दैट व्हेन अ जीवा डिपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस बॉडी ही हैज इन विजन ऑफ व्हाट द नेक्स्ट एम्बॉडीमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी एंड विद दैट विजन ऑफ व्हाट माय नेक्स्ट एम्बॉडीमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी विद दैट ही डिपार्ट्स दैट्स व्हाई ही रीचेस दैट नेक्स्ट एम्बॉडीमेंट। सो सविज्ञान अन्वक्रामते Along with that knowledge, he departs and reaches that next embodiment. In this Sruteshya. Savijnanam vasanamatra vijnanarupana udbhutam ityartha. So at that time, the vasana arises. As Lord Krishna says, what will be the bhava at the end, at the time of death? Call it vasana. Whatever strong vasana was which he entertained during this life, that's what manifests itself for him and that's what determines, that's what he sees. That now I'm going to a tiger or a lion or a devata or a manushya or whatever. With that knowledge he departs and attains that next embodiment. So savijnanam eva anvavakramati Vasanamatra vijnanarupena udbhutam. That vision that arises before him in the form of the vasana. Then again the Tikakara quotes Brahma Sutra. Tadoko ugrajvalanam tat prakashitadvarah vidyasamartyat tashesha gati anusmriti yogacha हादानुग्रहित है शताधिक्यम यदि सूत्र चेदि भाव है लॉन्ग सूत्र सो दैट इज द 4-17 दैट सूत्र इज देयर नाउ यू कैन सी द टेक्स्ट तदोकोग्रज्वलनम व्हाट इज ओक ओक इज आधारपूर्ण हृदय इन दिस केस तत् मीन्स तस्य तत् ओकोग्रज्वलनम तस्य ओक अग्रज्वलनम तस्य लीन वृत्तिक वागादि समुदाय समुदाय से उत्क्रमिष्यत जीवस्य ऑफ द जीवा ऑफ हुम द वांग मन से संबद्धते द स्पीच इंडू माइंड माइंड इंडू प्राण प्राण इंडू तेजस तेजस इंडू सत दैट वन उत्क्रमिष्यत सो विद एवरीथिंग इज मर्ज इंटू फायर एंड फ्रॉम देयर देन विद दैट दैट इज द उदान वायु विद दैट ही डिपार्ट्स फ्रॉम हियर सो उत्क्रमिष्यत डिपार्टिंग फ्रॉम दिस बॉडी जीवस ओक है आधारभूतम हृदय ओकोग्रज्वलम तस्य अग्रम यद अग्रम ऊर्ध्वभाग है सो द टाइम ऑफ डिपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस बॉडी द जीवा वॉज इन द हार्ट दैट इज आधार एंड अग्रम मीन्स द टॉप ऑफ द हार्ट ऊर्ध्वभाग तस्य ज्वलनम दैट बिकम्स लाइटेड अप सो प्राप्तव्य ज्ञान रूपम द्योतनाख्यम प्राप्तव्य ज्ञान रूपम सो व्हाट्स द लाइटिंग अप ऑफ द टॉप ऑफ द हार्ट द नॉलेज और द विजन दैट इज गोइंग टू हैव नाउ ऑफ व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट एम्बॉडीमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी द्योतनाख्यम आदौ भवति दैट्स हैपेंस तत् प्रकाशित द्वार सूत्र तत् प्रकाशित द्वार व्हाट इज इट तेन द्योतनेन प्रकाशित द्वार प्रदर्श देवयान मार्ग दिस सूत्र इज पर्टिकुलर इन केस ऑफ एन उपासक ए पर्सन हु स्पेंड द होल ऑफ हिज लाइफ इन मेडिटेटिंग अपॉन सगुण ब्रह्म सो दिस सूत्र इज मेन बिकॉज द फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ द ब्रह्म सूत्र इज ऑल दिस the sadhanam, you know, and so what path, etc., he departs from. So, tat prakashita dvara hai, tena dyotanena prakashita dvara, tat prakashita dvara means tena prakashita dvara hai, tena dyotanena prakashita dvara hai, prakashita pradashita devayana marga hai. So, top of his heart becomes lighted up, and there he sees what the next passage is going to be. The jiva, the upasaka knows, he's going to pass now through the devayana marga. Vidvan, avidvamsya bhavati. Both upasaka and non-upasaka. For both of them, it is the same. Tatra vidvan, sthanantarebhyo nishkramati. Ignorant person departs from sthanantarebhya, from apertures other than the murdha. So the saguna brahma upasaka departs from the top of the head, from brahmarandra. Umityekaksharam brahma vyaharan mamanusmaran yah prayati tyajandeham sayadi paramam gatim. So saguna brahma upasaka, om, om, and also seeing the meaning of that word, he departs from the top of the head and he reaches Brahmaloka. So, but then, ignorant person in this case, one who has not done this upasana, who has not realized Saguna Brahma, so he is not evolved to that point. So this upasana, evolved person, one is not evolved, he departs through lower aperture. The highest aperture is Brahmarandra. From lower apertures, depending on his karma, he departs. So even if he departs, eyes, etc., is supposed to be good. Higher the aperture, higher the gati. Lower the aperture, lower. That's our manyata, you know. Comes from all of this description anyway. So avidvan sthanantarebhya nishkramati. The one who has not done the meditation departs from the apertures that are lower than the Brahmarandra. विद्वांस तो मूर्द स्थान आदेव वे विद्वान द उपासक है फ्रॉम द मूर्द स्थान है फ्रॉम द टॉप ऑफ द हेड कुतः ऑन व्हाट बेसिस डू यू से दैट सो सूत्र से विद्या सामर्थ्यात ज्ञान बलात् विद्या हियर मीन्स द उपासना द आइडेंटिटी द रियलाइजेशन विद्या इज रियलाइजेशन ऑफ सगुण ब्रह्म सो विद्या सामर्थ्यात ऑन द सामर्थ्य द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द रियलाइजेशन ऑफ सगुण ब्रह्म ज्ञान बलात् यदि नाम सविद्योपि विद्यारहितवत् इतर स्थानेभ्यो विनिष्क्रामेत नैव उत्कृष्टं फलं लभेत यदि नाम अविद्योपि सविद्योपि इव पर्सन हु हैज नाउ डन द उपासना एंड रियलाइज ही आल्सो डिपार्ट्स फ्रॉम द लोअर अपर्चर्स देन ही वुड नॉट गेट द हाईएस्ट रिजल्ट ननु स्थानांतरेभ्योपि उत्क्रामन् उत्कृष्टं फलं प्राप्नुयात् So the question is, why don't you say that whichever aperture you depart from, that you get the exalted result, why not? Why do you say that the exalted result comes only when you depart from the top of the head, why not from other apertures also? Then says, tashyeshagati, then again part of the sutra, tashyeshagati anusmriti yogacca. तस्शेष गति अनुस्मृति योगाच तस्याः सगुण विद्यायाः शेषभूता या गति ही मूर्धन्य नाड़ी स्मृति ही सी ड्यूरिंग द उपासना नॉट ओनली दिस उपासक और मेडिटेटर इज आस्ट टू मेडिटेट अपॉन द सगुण ब्रह्म इष्ट देवता इज ऑल्सो आस्ट टू मेडिटेट अपॉन द पाथ अलॉन्ग विच ही इज गोइंग टू ट्रैवल सो दैट नाड़ी Also, he has been meditating upon, so, Murdanya Nadi Smriti, the Nadi along with he is going to depart, that also is meditating, so that is why he remembers which passage I have to go through. Tasya Anusmriti Dhyanam Tad Yogat Tad Vijnanacca, because in part of meditation was meditating upon that passage also. Ini Sthanantarebhyopi निष्क्रामतोपि विशिष्ट फल प्राप्ति स्यात् तर्हि विशिष्ट गति चिंतन विधान व्यर्थमेव स्यात् इफ यू गेट द एक्सॉल्टेड आउटकम इन स्पाइट ऑफ डिपार्टिंग फ्रॉम द लोअर अपर्चर्स ऑल्सो देन व्हाई शुड श्रुति आस्क दिस उपासक टू ऑल्सो मेडिटेट अपॉन दिस नाडी सो व्हाई डू दिस प्रिस्क्राइब बिकॉज यू डिपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट बिकॉज यू गेट एक्सॉल्टेड गति Otherwise, if the result is the same, this meditation upon this Murdhanadi would have been meaningless. It cannot be meaningless, therefore, there must be a specific result. That's the Shrutya Arthapatti. Atah dhirgakala nairantarya satkarahi dhudamasevitena dhirgakala. So meditation is for a long time. Nirantarya, constantly, satkara, with a great enthusiasm or commitment or devotion. Because of asevitena. So his heart has been now actually been, what shall I say? Because of this meditation constantly, his mind, his heart also has been accordingly influenced. So this constant long-time meditation has also transformed his mind and transformed his heart. So harda anugruhitah, hardena brahmana anugruhitah. Because all of his life he is only meditated upon saguna brahma, therefore he gets anugraha, the grace of saguna brahma at the time of death. तद्भाव आपन्नो विद्वान सो विद्वान नाउ मेडिटेट आइडेंटिफाई सगुण ब्रह्म शताधिकया शत अधिक मीन्स व्हाट शतादपि अधिकया नाड्या 100 प्लस मीन्स व्हाट 101 सो 100 नाडीज गो इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन द वन कम्स टू द टॉप मूर्धन्य निष्क्रामते The idea is that the upasaka of Saguna Brahma departs only from the Murdan, and other people depart from the lower aperture. So that's what that sutra says, and that's what is quoted here. To say that how a person attains the gati or the next destination or embodiment depending upon the vasana, depending upon what is always thought about. Sada tad bhava bhavitah. All the life he has meditated upon Ishta Devata, and therefore at the time of departure he gets the grace of Ishta Devata, because his heart or mind is completely transformed into Ishta Devata. So his body is not transformed, but his mind is transformed because of constant meditation. So by the grace of that, the time of departure now, he has that vision of what he is going to attain. And that's how he attains that destination, that gati. Easy. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamivavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeri Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.